Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Suraj Gurung, student manager of Sri Balaji Society, BITM. I am so excited to be here today and to have the opportunity to introduce our guest speaker, Ms. Annapurna ma'am. Annapurna ma'am is HR thought leader and possesses more than 20 years of rich experience in HR operations, management, leadership, and organization development. Her astounding industrial experience was with companies like Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Raman Boards, Manhattan Associates, Essilor, ETOE Rail Infrastructure, etc. Presently, she heads the country HR as Director HR for Inspirage Software Private Limited. She has earned many recognitions to her credit. She renders social service as volunteer and fundraiser to Balimane and Sumangali Seva Ashram, wherein girl child and women empowerment is the focus. Ladies and gentlemen, on a final note, she is also a fascinating individual who drives people with a caring attitude, and we all are grateful for her presence amongst us today. Now I would like to request Ms. Annapurna ma'am to enlighten her knowledge to all our student managers.
This is really a big punishment standing here. I don't like to stand like this, but I think because of the setup, if I stand there, I would not be able to see those audience. So I will take this opportunity to stand over here and talk to you. And with all riders which I'm going to give, all the guys sitting over there, you can happily sleep because I'm not going to talk any rocket science. And top guys, I don't know how much of eye contact I will be doing it. So you're also at freedom to close your eyes and listen to me if it makes sense for you. Else, just go and have a nice peaceful rest because it's last lecture or last talk of the day. I know it's very difficult because from morning you guys have been continuously listening. What is the future of you? I too really don't know, you know, what's the future. But having said that, I am from business. Okay, my family is of docs and stuff like that, but that's different. But I'm purely dhande mein hoon yaar. Okay? And I only understand only one thing, that's business. Okay? So, jaise Modi ji bolte hai na, dhanda karo yaar, dhanda karo. So, bas hum business wale hain. Okay? So, I don't know how many of you are from Marwari families over here, but great respects to them and big salutes. You all have... Okay, guys, you need to... I know you are in the last session of the day because this session is going to end at night 12 o'clock only. So please be careful. You have to listen to me. Otherwise, I will be stopping you guys. So if you wanted me to complete it in the next 1 hour time and set you free, then allow me to speak. If you want to be there till night 12 o'clock, because I have time till night 12, so you can be making a lot of noise. Okay, that's the deal. That's the first deal as a business manager. Dhanda acha hai? Bilkul. Aur kya? Marwari log, they have made it to the Harvard studies, you know. You see in the family, everyone does dhanda. Yes or no? Yeah, so it's an official thing, okay? Don't think dhanda is a bad word. Aaj dhanda nahi hua, toh kuch bhi nahi hua hai. Okay? And please, Masters of Business Administration, MBA stands for. I give full clarity to that. It is not Masters of Badmash Administration. Okay. With this, let's go and understand this. This is a very favorite slide for me. As long as you are living, you have to be changing. So there is no scope. You have to change. Okay. You would have not expected me to be coming over here from Bangalore, but that's a surprise for you and me, and that's change for us both. Right? So that's where it is. As long as we are alive, we have to change, and we are changing. Okay. That's a very surprising thing. It's a very far-off slide for you, but I will help you in reading this slide. It's a very interesting and a very nice, and my slides are going to be all about data, statistics, analysis. So don't go on seeing, because I like numbers. And I have just scraped through in mathematics. Doesn't mean that I'm not good in numbers. I love numbers. Okay, now they see this. The top I think one big hand lens we just put, it's talking about you will be retiring at the age of 70 plus, 74 it is put actually in that slide, okay? If you can zoom there, we can see that 74. So that means your retirement age is not anymore 58 or 60. And that's a huge long period of work life. And you have to stay for that much work life. Do you have so much of jobs to be there? That's the question which is coming up over there. So what kind of jobs we will be having? Today we are seeing that every moment technology is changing. Every moment disruptions are happening. And every moment they're telling that you are laid off, right? Pune is the first city who told IT layoff is not done. We want to form unions. Yes. Okay. So there are a lot of changes which are happening to the whole of the industry. And this is one change which is bigger change, because you are going to this millennial people will have a longer life. They will have a longer work life. And 74 is a predicted age which they will retire. And are there jobs for that kind of things? Jobs are shrinking. Okay, skills are changing. So who wants change? No one wants change. Who wants change? Kisko badalna chahiye? Kisi ko usko badalna chahiye? Mere ko badalna nahi chahiye? Hai ki nahi? Main kyun badlun? Wo badale? That's a simple answer we get every time, right? And every day mom keeps on shouting, can you get up early and go? I know, I'm sure now you're all there in hostel. You will put your own alarms and get up. But if you were in home and still continuing to be going on holidays, and your moms will be telling, when will you change? I will never change. You change. As simple as it. Right. So who wants change? No one wants change. But who wants others to change? Everyone wants. Okay. This is an interesting, again, millennial dynamics of 2017 internet minute. In 60 seconds, we are seeing, at least in Facebook, we have 9 lakh logins. Twitter, Instagram, anything, Tinder, take LinkedIn, Messenger. You're all there. As we speak, I'm sure half of you are being on WhatsApp right now. Half of you are Insta there. And maybe someone is seeing a pin interest or putting pins or something and all. That's internet life. 60 seconds, you see what's happening. It's an internet minute which you are putting over there. So where are the guys? The guys are all here. Where should I find talent? Where is the marketing happening? Who are the customers? Where are the consumers? The consumers are all here. I'm reading a lot of books, a lot of concepts, and a lot of things. But the consumers are here. The talent is over here. And business is happening here. Okay? 75% to 80% of the business is happening in this stage. People are there on LinkedIn. People are there on Pinterest, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Reddit, Instagram. And there is the internet of all things which is there, over there. A lot of IoT is happening. So are we ready for this game? What is this digital thing which we are talking about? What is it IoT? What is cloud? So these are the things which are going to catch up in the era now which is going to come up. And believe me, friends, if you have to just take the example of HR, which I represent, and I have been doing this from last 20 years for different organization, in my own journey of life, if I have to hire someone previously, 20 years back, I used to put a recruitment advertisement in newspapers, in some other things and things like that. Today, I just go by WhatsApp. I just put a small ad and tell, hey, I'm looking for an L&D manager, I'm looking for a recruitment, and it's all reference. Then I go, I scout, I do analytics on LinkedIn or on Facebook or on Twitter or on Pinterest. I just figure out, hey, this is the guy who is available. What has been his background? What is his interest? How is he replying to any Facebook post? How is he doing on LinkedIn? Did he write a blog, etc.? Furthermore, we are now having something called video analytics. We are having something called completely a resume analytics, which we see. So where when we just see a CV and we just put it and mismatch, I mean match the profile with all the social digital content which you have already put on different ways. And that throws up a profile for us telling that, hey, this guy on communication, he will range anything between 7 to 10. Anything between presentation like this, interpersonal skills are like this, or any of those competencies which you see, technical know-how. That means how many times you have really gone and searched something new other than something fashion? How many times you have gone and seen what's happening in car industry or automobile industry or bike industry? Or how many times have you seen or even followed on Twitter something politicians or some sports person or things like that and all? So these are the analytics which are going to come out through us. And then we will see, understand the profile of the individual telling that, okay, this is the kind of the guy who is there in front of us. So what this guy can do? What are the talent he can bring out to us and all? So it's a lot to do with a lot of social content which is already there to see further where one fits in the organization or what kind of jobs we are going to see for the future in force for us. Okay, let's see this very nice video and then you can tell what are the future of jobs.
Hey, some kind of a evolution that's forcing organizations to think differently about what it means to be an employee or a manager, and even what it means to actually work. There are five trends that are causing this evolution to happen. Five trends that are forcing organizations to challenge everything they know about work. These five trends are globalization, mobility, millennials and changing demographics, new behaviors, and technology. Globalization is causing the world to become like one giant city. The language that you speak, the culture that you subscribe to, the currency that you transact in, and where you are physically located are all starting to matter much less. This means that organizations can tap into talent anywhere in the world. Mobility is allowing us to stay connected to people and information anytime, anywhere, and on any device. This means that work is no longer a place you go to, it's something that you carry with you in your pocket wherever you are. Millennials are expected to comprise 50% of the workforce by 2020 and 75% of the workforce by 2025. Millennials are digital natives that expect and want to work in ways that reflect the year we live in. Most people live in 2015, but work at companies that operate like they are in 1975. Although millennials are driving enormous organizational change, it's important to remember that the future employee is anyone that is changing their behavior and mindset to adapt to the changing workforce. This means it doesn't matter if that person is 22 or 62. New behaviors are rapidly entering our organizations. For example, we are all comfortable living a more public life. We share our thoughts in blogs, post reviews on Yelp, have our entire professional history on LinkedIn, share pictures on Instagram, rant on Twitter, and engage in open conversations on Facebook. In fact, virtually every aspect of business behavior has changed, including the way we share, communicate, collaborate, teach, learn, find information, access technology, and create content. This is forcing organizations to fundamentally rethink and reimagine the way we work. Technology such as big data, wearable devices, collaboration platforms, the Internet of Things, and cloud computing are enabling us to work in new ways while keeping us more engaged and productive. In the future of work, technology is the central nervous system of the organization that enables everything else to function. Together, these five trends combined with an unprecedented war for talent is forcing organizations to shift their mentality from creating a place where they assume employees need to work there to creating an environment where employees want to work there. When we think about the future of work, the organizations that can most effectively make this shift from need to want are the ones who will be able to attract and retain top talent. This means that if your organization doesn't think about and plan for the future of work, then your organization will have no future.
So that's something which is coming up, and that's where they're asking that even organizations are being asked with the questions, because 75% of the workforce by 2025 will be millennials. Millennials means you and next you. Okay, that's Gen Y and the next Gen Z, which we are calling out. Those are the millennials who are come out, and they are different. They want to work everything on the internet. They want to have challenging jobs. They have to have decisions making faster. They have disruptive technologies with them, and they wanted to challenge everything which has been as a process from long time. So today, cloud is giving an answer for ERP solutions, which was being done for ages. If supposing an ex-organization has to put an ERP system in their organization, it used to take months and years. Today, we are talking about an organization which I am representing. We are telling cloud computing in 90 days. We are going to put for you a solution in 90 days, an ERP solution. So that's where it is coming up. That's a change which is coming up. So imagine in every part of the business, everywhere there is a change which is happening. So we need to be agile to see what are these technologies which are coming up. We have to create organizations in such a way where people want to come and do work. And today work doesn't mean 8 to 5, 8 to 8 and all. You carry work everywhere. It's just that's it. You take mid intervals, but you carry your work everywhere and you start delivering it whenever, wherever required. So let's this acronym has become a very important acronym, though it has been formed in 1970s in the Palestine war and stuff like that, where army was talking about this acronym called VUCA. VUCA has been very, very old terminology, but it has been more used today. VUCA stands for V as volatility, U for uncertainty, and C for complexity, and A for ambiguity. So every moment of our life, what we are sharing today, we are staying in a VUCA world. That means every moment there is a change, every moment there is an ambiguity, there is so much of complexity in things we do, the way we do, and how we are expected to do. So just see the skill shortages, how it is. And India stands somewhere in 64% after Japan, where we don't have. Still though, we are having so many other countries there, and India is there on the top two. We don't have skills. And this is something very interesting. These are the technologies we have to talk about. And I will come back to slides after all this. So what is it in Fermi? I will answer that question also. But this is something very interesting. We are having something called natural language processing, video analytics. Video analytics, I've recently seen an app, a beautiful app which has been developed by one of my friends, and it's superb, which we are talking about in recruitment. Then there is biometrics, facial recognition, gesture recognition, neural networks, and mini bots. So we are talking about inside technologies like deep learning, machine learning, artificial intelligence, bots who are going to take away. Okay? This is what is going to happen. You're liking going to like this, you're not going to like this, it's nothing going to matter. Because this has already hit our all zones. Today, do you know there were age-old washing machines, but today there is a washing machine which can, do every operation and then your clothes are dry and just you have to spread them. What is there happening? The machine has learned, machine has intelligence, which has already put it in that. You have refrigerators which has its own intelligence for that. You have all gadgets which are coming with a lot of intelligence. You're having your own smart phones. How many of you are having iPhones? Yeah? Siri, wake me up. Siri, kill my mom. This was a four-year child told that, who was taking that and using Siri and told kill. Sorry, I don't understand your question. You can Google it, told. Siri didn't understand that question. But then you see, what is it? Wearables, Fitbits. How many of you are using Fitbit? Yeah? Why do you use it? Because it's a wearable. You are able to understand what's happening over there. Okay? Some are brands. People wear things for brands. It's no more going to be a brand. It's going to be technology which is going to be eating away in your life. You are going to become slave of technology more and more. But does that mean that we will not have jobs? Or does that mean that what is human going to do? A bigger question in front of us. Right? Let's see what is it we'll do. See this statistics. This is a statistics which is coming out from B schools. Most of there, you see entrepreneurs, how they're developing the demography. India is the youngest startup nation in the world. 72% of the founders are less than 35 years old. That means straight off the college, straight from B school, they get an idea, they just put it up, they nurture it. Beyond 35, no one wants to take risk. If you see entrepreneurs between 41 to 45 or above 45, we have very less percentage. So that's where we are seeing. Again, gender is improving, but not equal. But then it's catching up. Again, all these budding entrepreneurs are now again into new technologies. They're not going by their parental home, entrepreneurships or businesses or something. They are again creating some disruptions to the whole nations and seeing that we are coming out with new solutions and things like that. So that's something on the startups and things like that. And like it or do not like it, nation as it is going on a digital wave, or world is going on a digital wave. So you are seeing automotive truck industry, consumer industries, electricity industry, logistic industry, all contributing to the digital. Okay? So where are we if we are not there? If you are not able to see what's there, then how digital transformation has a greater value and stake in the society at large. So you like or you're not going to be there or not, you have to embrace this, which is going to come up. Let's play this video before that, and then we can go to the next slide.
This is the story of a young man. His name is John. You might even know him.
Yeah, hi, John.
John has been a smart boy since he was young. He is athletic and popular. He plays the guitar once in a while and loves playing basketball. John grows up, goes to college, and graduates with good grades. He is young and unstoppable. He wants to change the world. You remember that stage of your life? John's dream is to be the world's most successful investor, the next Warren Buffett. And to make his dream come true, John makes his first move. He applies for a job as a junior financial analyst. Brimming with hope and ambition, John sends out applications to all the major investment banks. And to his horror, he was rejected by all of them. John is crushed, weighed down by disappointment and confusion. He talks to his favorite economics professor, Professor Pawlowski. John asks, "Professor Pawlowski, what's happening? I don't get it. The economy is recovering. Am I not good enough?" Professor Pawlowski laughs and said, "Don't be too hard on yourself. The economy is experiencing a jobless recovery. Companies are making more money, but hiring less people." John is now confused. "How is that possible?" Professor Pawlowski explains, "It's really simple. Many junior jobs are now done by algorithms, not humans. The banks don't need junior analysts like you to analyze data. Algorithms can do it a million times faster than you. Technology has automated blue-collar jobs in the past. Now it's starting on skilled white-collar jobs too." John is really worried. "I can't compete with algorithms. Am I ever going to find a job?" Professor Pawlowski laughs again. "You worry too much. The economy is still in good shape. When we look back in time to the Industrial Revolution, we see that technology replaced many farming jobs. But in the long term, technology created more jobs in factories. And if we fast forward to the future, technology is replacing white-collar jobs now, but will create new jobs in the long term. The key, my boy, is the long term." John is relieved. "Phew, I was so scared. But when will that be? 2 years? That's pretty long. More like 20 years. John flips. 20 years is forever. I can't wait 20 years for technology to create new jobs." Professor Pawlowski isn't so worried. "Your career is like climbing a ladder leading up to your dreams. Algorithms aren't going to replace all jobs. They are cutting away the bottom rungs of the job ladder, but they reinforce the really high-skilled jobs at the top rungs. You just have to keep trying, and you'll be fine." Now this leaves John more confused than ever. What's he supposed to do? Should he take up some minimum wage, boring work? Not really. Or should he keep trying for the higher level, higher wage work that he is trained for and really wants? How can he build the skills needed to reach the top of the ladder? What if he never gets there? What should John do? What should all of them do?
So what should all of us do now? This is exactly where we are there now. There are no more mundane routine jobs where you go, you wanted to become a salesperson, where you want to become a marketing person, HR person, operation executive. There are no jobs. Just go and do all your studies and see it and check it. These are the jobs which will fade away hardly next 12 months to 18 months. By the time you're out in 2019 or 18, when are you going to get out? 18, yeah. I don't feel some of the jobs will really be there. Some of those profiles would have, which has come to your campus as JD, they're not going to be there. So how should I get prepared? What are those jobs going to come? What are those profiles which are going to be there? What do organizations will see as you guys coming and having something as a different roles in the organizations? This is the question which is to be answered today. Right? When you talk about your theme called futuristic skills for B schools, this is the question which we are there in front of us. Okay, I tried to attempt to answer this so that it could give you some type of idea or guidance for this. And let's see what it is. So what should a B school student like me do? I don't know how many of you have come across this iceberg theory. This is a very high, very, very old theory wherein you know all the skills and knowledge which is there, and there is a beneath which is the all the behaviorals and traits over there. Okay, but today even those knowledge and skills have to be changed. If I study marketing in my B school, will I be able to apply that? Or should I study something else with that knowledge? Or what are the skills which I have to take up along with my content? What are those behaviors and traits which I need to exhibit to get onto the jobs? So just see this model. This model I have developed for you last night, and I was trying to attempt at it. If I am one of the students on that side, what should I do? That was a question I posed for myself. So first thing what I would do is, in whatever stage of my semesters I am right now, I would immediately do a health checkup of myself. That means I will do a SWOT analysis of myself. Where am I? What are my strengths? What are my weaknesses? What are my opportunities? And what are my threats? This is something to begin with. Once you start doing something like that, I don't know how many of you have gone through this something called mind map. Do you understand mind map? Have you done any time mind mapping? Okay, even if you have not understood or if you have not done mind mapping to a large extent, I would just simply do a very simple mind map. That means 2018 is your milestone, right? 2018, June, July, you would be finishing your studies. Work backwards on that. Put yourself in the center. Put all the events which are going to happen and what kind of SWOT you are having score with you, and then map it up and see where do you exactly position yourself and where do you want to be there. This is the second step. If you could do, it would help you. The third is what sort of content you are having with you. That meaning, if you have studied something as a subject, if you are having some concepts which you have studied, do you feel those concepts are really going to be put into practice? Do you see those industries putting those concepts into practice, or those concepts have evolved into better ways and things like that? So what is the content enrichment I should do around that? That meaning, if supposing I have seen something as a practice in 2000s early, so 2020, would that remain as a process still, or the process has gone around and has a change? Today, when you sit in front of certain people and do interviews, people would like to exactly understand, do you understand past? Do you understand present? Do you understand future? If you are able to bring a correlation between these three, that is where the people will tell, hey, this is the person who is content enriched. That's what it is. This is a big time subject. It is called content leadership. If you wanted to read more about it, you can go and see a McKinsey report on this. This is a leading thing, which is as a competency, which is required across people. It is not something with you or me. It is required for all of us that we become content rich. Once you are content rich, okay, I have repeated that. What kind of research you are going to do on that? Okay, that's the place where you are going to put it with analytics. No one would love your content when you go and tell that, hey, I know this is what it is, this is what it is, blah, 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 you will do. No one would tell. Backed up with research, backed up with lot of data. That means analytics. Data as it is doesn't have any meaning. Understood? It is just information and data. That's it. We don't have anything to do with it. The moment you will bring a feather to it and add to it and do a proper analytics to it, that is where the data gets enriched. And then we will come back to you and tell, hey, you have done an analytics around this. Okay? So why does my product fail? If you tell, hey, look, if you go to HUL and tell that next couple of years, I don't feel this product, XYZ product, is going to be there in the market because this product is having a lot of problems. It is, and the other thing, it is not biodegradable, possible. There is a huge thing which is coming on environment and e-business, okay? So there people are talking about why should we even do this? Carbon footprint, if you wanted to reduce that, it's a boardroom talk today. Diversity is a big time talk in boardrooms today. So there are a lot of things if you're going to bring a lot of dimensions to it and then put it and tell HUL as a campus guy, if you go and put this on the table, there is no more interview, my dear friends. Believe me, one of you do this, if you're not getting going to get succeeded, you can come and challenge me. Today we wanted someone to put this on the to the tables. We are telling, if supposing a HR students come to me and talk about, hey, I don't feel your compensation strategy is fine. I tell, okay, fine, I take that. But then what do you, can you suggest me a strategy by doing something? Yes, I do have a strategy because I have seen 10 other different IT companies, consulting companies, and this is what it would be there. You will have 5 to 6 generations working. So you should make a compensation structure like this. And this is the analytics which I could give. If you're going to be like this, it won't work for you. So that's something which we are talking about, predictive analytics. Can you be in that space? Can you work something, models on that? And bring from the data to research, to analytics, Internet of Things, and data science. And then put it back and tell that you are the new generation hots. Because your bots are going to take away your jobs, but you are the new generation, higher order thinking human beings. Okay? If you can come up with like this, if you can come up with these sort of solutions for any industries and sit in your interviews and talk to, engage with any of the managers or the leaders on these type of things, I don't feel that there is any depth for any campus to have being seeing that we will not get placed. Please do your homework right from today. Right from today. You have to work on this. And this is the only thing which is going to be a saver, I'm telling you. Believe me, friends. Because we will not accept someone who is going to come with an MBA passport and will to the corporate and telling that, hey, and we ask some question and they tell, hey, we didn't study this chapter. In selection, I left this chapter. God save you. Please get out. That would be the answer. Very brutal. Please go ahead. Do this thing. If you feel this is my model, I just put it out of my head. I thought, hey, this is what can work. But if you feel something better can be done, let's evolve. Let's work together to see if something better model can be done. And we work back for 2018 and see how this cannot work. Okay. So apart from this, I would show something. These are the challenges which have come. This is from, again, from a Harvard study which has happened. And Dr. Tony was talking about there are 2 major trends in the world that pose a fundamental challenge and many opportunities. It's posing a challenge and it's opening up opportunities also to our educational system. One is the world is shifting from an industrial economy to a knowledge economy, which we all have to embrace it. The other is the rising generation brought up on the internet, completely brought on the internet. So what are you teaching? Books, Kindle, everything. I mean, all that what is happening in classrooms, etc. and all, you always also would like to see that there is internet which is being backed up. So there is a lot of, he is very differently motivated to learn. So this generation and the next who is going to come, we will not be having, I don't know whether we'll have such huge infrastructure to teach them. We will be doing the same kind of pedagogy of teaching and things like that. But this is what it is. So these 2 forces argue. And Dr. Tony is telling to us, it compels us to reconceptualize education in this country. And in his thoughtful analysis of future industry needs and educational readiness studies, doctor says he has identified what he calls as global achievement gap. Global achievement gap, which is the leap between even our best schools are teaching and the must-have skills in the industry or of the skills of the future. That's what it is. That's the global. So there is nowhere we are correlating or we are very nearer to what is happening in industry. Okay? Thankfully, all the government institutions, I don't feel they're in some other era. We cannot even hire anyone from those institutions. Private institutions who are ready to listen what's happening in the industry are able to catch up the speed, allow their students to experiment and understand what is needed for tomorrow. 2018, what I need for my industry is a question should be there in front of you. If I have to join a pharma industry, if I have to join a FMCG industry, if I have to pick up any industry, IT, IT consulting, or e-digital, or e-business, or any of those industries, if you wanted to be there, retail, anywhere, what is it 2018 is looking at? What is their business plan? I may have a great company as my dream company, but do I know the financials of that company? Do I know the CEO of that company? Do I know the turnover of the company? Do I understand what kind of business they are into? What kind of investments will be they doing? As a business student, if I don't understand all of that and go tomorrow for an interview, I'm sorry, they will tell that, hey, you are not a right fit for me. Rather, if you talk their language, they'll tell, come, here is the offer for you. So this is something which Tony has figured out. And then he came up with 7 critical skills for careers, college, and global citizenship he's talking about. He's talking about critical thinking and problem solving. Understood? So that's a crucial skill he's putting up. He's telling, can I critically think and give a solution to the problem? First. Second, collaboration across networks and leading by influence. Can I collaborate? Can I participate? If I'm there on LinkedIn, it's not that I have 10,000 connections, but out of those connections, how do I make the best use of those connections? Right? Then how do I build networks? How do I make networks, neural networks, which can help me to grow and enhance my career? Then how do I lead by influence? Can I influence other person? Can I influence his ideas, thoughts, ideologies, me as such, and market myself? So today the game of marketing is changing. It is called influencing marketing, influencing leadership. Can I be an influencer leader? That's where we are talking about. Agility and adaptability. Anywhere, because every time, every moment technology is changing, can I be agile? Can I understand that? Can I be able to adapt to those things? No? Can I manage change? That's the question in front of us. Initiative and entrepreneurism. I take initiative, no one need not come to me and tell that, hey, you take the initiative in the organization. Can I start myself something? Can I innovate? Can I take some initiative? Being an entrepreneur, it is not no more manager. Everyone is an entrepreneur. Every individual in an organization has to think, live, and dream of like to become an entrepreneur. When you think and dream of like an entrepreneur, that's when you bring profitability. And no business is without profitability. Sorry. If you tell any business is without it's for charity, that's a different organization. I have to be in business means profitability is the only goal for me to be in business. Effective oral and written communication. My friends, I would like to talk about this because I have literally seen at least in across India business schools, wherein I would say with lot of pain in my heart that not even 20% of students are good at this. Oral and written communication. And it is the most important skill. And why are we not putting effort to understand how can we build communication? Effective communication. It is not something that it is conversation. Conversation is different. And I pretty well understand India is a big country. India is having thousands of dialects. Every 50 miles, we have different languages, different food, different diversity, etc. But do not bring the nativity into English. English is unfortunately our international only one language to do business. Helpless, but it's the only language. When you sit with US folks, till today, till this morning, till even this moment, I'll tell you, we have challenges. They will not accept. And today, like or dislike, India's economy is not on par with US or UK or any of those Brits economies. We still have to fight those economies. And when we have to fight with those economies and we have to become there, when we have to showcase our talent, we have to talk. Effective communication is one of the most important competency. Please build it up. Experiment it here. Do not come to the workplace and experiment. It is going to be a disaster for you. Only because of this one important very skill, many, many of the managers have been told, sorry, you're not going to be in the system. Please put efforts to build this competency. English is important. There is no way for us. We may talk 10,000 other dialects or languages, but this becomes very important for us. Please put efforts on that. Accessing and analyzing information. When you talk about data science, when you talk about big data, okay, you will be having, not, I think here around 1,000 students are there. We have 1,000 MIS about them? Yes. Placement cells are having? Yes. They do have, whether he's a male, female, which language, fathers, what is it, mother, what is it, what is the, anything. What have we done with the data? What have we done? Humongous data. Think about it. What can you do with this data? How this data can help us? Build data models. You can do it. You have lots of data over here. How could I research that? How could I put best into practice over there? So that's where we are talking about accessing and analyzing information. Whenever any information is passing through you, please don't leave it. Analyze it. Lot of analysis is required, because tomorrow you cannot just sit and tell illogically, hey, I cannot just tell this makes logic. Illogically, I'm making a logic. Sorry. What? How do I take it to that one? So please put efforts to understanding. First is accessibility. Yaar, tumhe kahan se mila? Yaar, usko mila to mere ko kyun nahi milega? As simple as it. That's it, right? When everything is there, every information is there. It's just that how can you get to access to data? How can you analyze the data? Okay, that's there. Curiosity and imagination. It is told that 5 years and below, every child asks, why is the sky blue? Once at least in the life. Yes or not? Yes. Why is the sky blue, mama? Why is the sky blue, dada? Sky is blue, that's it. Don't ask this question anymore. The answer. Because we don't know. Google was not there to tell it is sky is actually black and we are seeing it from so much of distance. That's why it looks for our eye, this one. Who has told all that? Sometimes science teacher has told you in 7th or 8th standard. By the time you are 13 or 14, you learnt it is not blue, it's black. But still we sing linearly number pay. That's fine for us. Right? So curiosity, let it not die. Be curious. Be curious, but not suspicious. Okay? Be curious. Be curiosity has to be one of our top skills, which we have to be there. Why is it being like this? Why can't it be done like that? If at all any scientist who have discovered or innovated or done anything till today has not been curious, just think this statement. If anyone who would have not done any revolution for us and they would have not been curious enough, then we would have not had any discoveries. We would have been those early man without clothes, and I don't know whether rocks were to be used for us for fire or not. Some early man discovered and he was curious, put both the rocks together and made fire. Then the wheel. And today we are racing. Just a wheel. Just the invention of wheel. And today we are always, always on wheel. And what wheel we are doing, I don't know. We are wheeling. So please see that curiosity is maintained. Imagination is maintained. Go beyond imagination. Don't imagine weird things. Imagine and reflect right things. That's important. Imagination can be anything, because at your age, you can imagine lots. Right? Because you're not constrained for imagination. So please be imagining things, but then put the right imagination, because that is much required. And this is, if you want to study more on this, there is a very famous, nice article called Global Achievement Gap by Tony, and you can go and refer that. You will get lots of information on this. But these seven skills, work on this. These seven skills, please work on this. This will help you to really achieve something to your 2018 goals. Okay? So new way for new gen hot, that is you are the new gen hot. So that is the book for still information. Wagner points out that in today's digital age, the next generation is amongst other things accustomed to instant gratification. So that's what he's telling. He's telling this is a spoiled generation. So every time if you're seeing a niece or a nephew in your own surrounding, immediately they do something, they just touch the phone, then there your mama or mommy or your uncles, aunts, everything, wow, the kid has done wonders. Wow, you instantly gratify. And that fellow thinks, oh, he has done great things. Yeah, because that's millennial. Millennial wants instant gratification. Corporate will never give instant gratification. Not only instant, never gratification. That's something which is there. Of course, now we started willingly to do that. Not having wanting, but willing, just willing. Just some will we are putting. And use of the web of extending friendships. See these words. Accustomed to instant gratification and use of the web for extending friendships. All your Facebook guys, I don't feel you would have seen them. But you have extended friendship with them. Interest-driven, self-directed learning and are constantly connected, creating and multitasking in a multimedia world everywhere except in school. Very interesting. He's saying that, hey, you both are neighbors, but then you don't speak to each other. You're studying in school, you're there as classmates, but you don't get connected with each other. But you're having millions of relationships on the web content. That's what he's pointing out. And in order to motivate and teach this generation, he's giving another advice for the B schools. The school system must be reinvented to be accountable for what matters most. And that means to do the work, teaching, learning, and assessing in new ways. So how do we assess students in new ways? How do we teach them in new ways? What kind of learning is something which we have to give? So this is something which has come out from this research. And students must acquire knowledge, but we need to use content to teach core competencies. So any institute which is rich in content building will sustain. That's very pretty clear. So my humble request, even to Balaji institutions or to students, develop content. You know, put efforts to build content. That's where we can acquire a lot of knowledge and then go a step ahead to do content analysis. So I would not leave that word with content analysis. I would tell what is content analysis. Content analysis is a research. So everything what you learn in your classrooms as concepts or something, get into the mode of the content, get into the mode of research. Ha, that gallery girls and boys, if you could pay another 5 minutes of attention, I would be done. Yeah, thank you. Content analysis is a research technique used to make replicable and valid inferences by interpreting and coding textual material. So whatever you have studied, whichever you have got it as a concept, that textual material is something which you are drawing inferences by systematically evaluating text, that is your documents which you are being given, oral communication which you are being given in your classrooms, graphics which you are being given, qualitative data can be converted into quantitative data. Although the method has been used frequently in social sciences, but recently it has become more prevalent among organization scholars like you and me. You are going to be in organizations. So we are going and embracing this. If you ask your research student, if you ask any of your professors over here who have done their PhDs, they would tell that, hey, we were following it from age-old methodology. It's not new for us. Yes, it was not new for them. They have been doing this. But this is, again, getting back into organizations. This is coming back and telling that, hey, if we do this, this is the way we have to do business. This is the way we have to run business houses. This is the way we have to learn every concept in ourselves. So my humble request to all the crowd, the young crowd who's going to come out to 2018 to see organizations, build rich content, understand those critical seven skills, work on them, do your SWOT analysis. We are there for you. We are waiting for you. There are a lot of organization leaders who can come here, stand here, be with you, mentor you, tell you what is required. Please, you understand where you want to be. First check, do your health check. Where you want to be in 2018? Should I go and see pharma industry? Should I see FMCG industries? Should I see IT industry? Based on your own backgrounds, based on your own SWOT analysis, if you conclude 3-4 areas where you wanted to work it, start doing research there. Start building your CV perfectly over there. Today, we don't wanted 5 pages of CV. We just want one page wherein it is crisp, it is graphical, it is beautiful. I don't know whether I can show you that, but then I had got a very good CV from a very young person. Very crisp, very beautiful. The CV itself tells that, hey, you recruit. That's how it is. Very graphical representation. So please be innovative. Please be creative and be curious. These are all the things which we wanted to tell to you. And this is what will definitely lead to your placement. If you want to be in industry. If you don't want to be in any organization, no problem. If you wanted to create an organization of your own, still the same things apply. If I want to be an entrepreneur, so be so. Start off. Okay? This is just an incubation period. This is not engineering 4 years where you're learning technical skills. This is MBA. Please be serious. I know this word sounds too professionalist. I don't want to be that professor talking. But I'm talking about serious in business. We want serious guys in business. Okay? If you may ask, Annapurna, don't you have fun at work? Fun at work is always there. Every moment is fun only. Because if you're not serious, then someone will make a fun for you. Well, before you start asking questions, I would like to also talk about the small aspect of diversity. India is a country which is of diversity. That's why we celebrate this independence and a lot of things and all. But today, when we talk about diversity, when we are coming, we are going to deal with global nations. We're going to deal with business with every different nations. So we will have our neighbor who's from Japan, or a gay sitting from Africa, or a Chinese sitting with us, or a Japanese with us. So now if you do not understand the cultural aspects of them, and the nuances of them, it's when we talk about gender, it is just not male and female. Do you know how many genders are there? How many? Three, four. That's all you're coming. From India, from South India, from Madurai, there is a research. Please go back and see there. The person has told there are 23 variants for gender. Huh. I don't know. Okay? So when you talk about lesbianism, there is something different. When you talk about gay, there is so many things. Transsexual genders. So there are male, female, transsexual, and so many other things. So today in workplace, LGBT rule has been passed. That means I am liable and I am supposed to, as complied, to even hire them as my talent. Okay? Tomorrow you cannot go and sit beside him and understand he's a gay. Hey, no, I will not work. Sorry, you have to work. Because he's bringing his intelligence over there. If he is harassing you, that's a harassment case. That we will take it separately. Understood? So be very careful because this is the global workforce which you are going to enter. Any organizations when you are entering, you will have this. So there are laws which are going to change. All the labor laws are getting changed. Now there are a lot of financial angles which are going to change. Because as a country, they're bringing change. As a world, the technology is improving. As society at a large, people are improving and enriching the lives. So they are telling, hey, talent doesn't mean that we have to ignore some society. We have to ignore women. Women are being taken care. Okay, we cannot ignore transsexual. We have to bring them. We cannot ignore people with disabilities. So we were bringing them. So it's a lot of inclusiveness. So we have moved away from the word called diversity. We're talking about inclusive work culture. So please be careful. These are all things which are going to be there. And when you are going to be asked with questions in your interviews, people will specifically pick up and ask these questions to understand what is your belief on that. They will trickle your mind and ask, hey, if you are there from here, if there is a Bengali guy who's next to you, will you be there? I am fine, you would say. But if he is a Bengali guy and he has been identified that he has been a gay, will you be fine? Now your eyes glow up and things like that happens. Sorry, what is it? Are you not an adult? Do you understand? People would ask you that. So please do not get into all that and stop all labeling here. Don't bring labels to corporates. It's very difficult. ये टमिलियन है, ये गोल्टी है, ये वॉट चिंकी है, मिंकी है, मंकी है. नो नो, यू आर ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एंड दैट्स इट. रिसेंटली आई हैड हेल्ड ए केस वेयर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड प्रिवेंशन ऑफ सेक्सुअल हैरेसमेंट इन वर्क प्लेस. दिस हैज कम फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट फॉर द वुमेन. Okay, it's only protecting women, but we have taken care of both the genders or whatever, how many of our genders are there. And now I'll tell you, there is a one simple example which I'm trying to give you. In one of the organizations, they have used, this girl has performed fantastically. And the boss and the team have told, you have done a mast job. So mast job has become mast ladki. And mast ladki, and it went to mast. She put pura sexual harassment case on the end. Entire team, she told, this is the labeling which my team is giving me. Please take action on that. Just see the words. And these are most commonly, we develop it from here. This is the birth of such things. Dude, yeah, we are not cool with dude. Chill, how can I chill? It's not so very cold that I should chill every time. No. my body is burning. I can't use any other words right now, but then it's everything is burning over here. And you're telling me to chill. I can't chill. My business is not at a place where I can chill. Cool dudes. And so many other words. Let's be cautious. Why am I telling these all these things is, 2018 is not far off, dear friends. It's 6 to 8 months. Work behind. Don't think the job will come, then I will think of all this. Start doing it from today. Build a good profession. You know, you should be a good professional. And professional, building a good professional image is the most toughest thing. Today, every CEO is under scanner. Every boardroom is under scan. That's where SEBI has put regulations telling that there should be independent directors. Why is it they're telling that you should be an independent director? Because they wanted to scan. Tata Mysteries case, it's there in front of you. There are many other big, big houses. Infosys, yes, what's happening in that? Flipkart, what's happening in that? Read all these cases. They're all in front of you. Why is this business houses having so many issues? What is it happening? When the second generation is coming? When the third generation is coming? And why are they fighting? What is all this happening? Read about investors. Read about economy. Embrace all this. At the end of it, to be a good business person, you have to be first a good professional. You know, first the profession has to be protected inside you. And then you can bring it. So my humble request is, please give a thought to all this, and then you can build up for your 2018. Thank you.
Ma'am, I wanted to ask something about the company that is Inspirage.
Yes.
I was going through your website.
Yes.
And we saw that you are into consulting mainly about logistics management, supply chain management, and there was something that really caught my attention, that is innovation management.
Right.
Can you please elaborate on that?
Brilliant. Yeah, I didn't talk about much about Inspirage because I thought that I should leave it to the people who are interested in joining Inspirage or wanting to be associated with us. So anyways, good question. Innovation management is our COE team, that is Center of Expertise, and we are the platinum partners for Oracle. Oracle does the product. Oracle does product of ERP solutions in SCM, HCM, finance, everything. And we are the Oracle Platinum Partners for SCM, that is Supply Chain Management. So when we talk about innovation management, it is just not what Oracle is building it and giving to the customers. It is also to see that what innovation we can bring as a value add to the customer. See, for example, supposing I am a large retail house. And I have been doing business across the world. And when Oracle has come and I wanted to embrace just the transportation management, but whereas the warehouse management, I want to keep it as a my homegrown system. It works well for me and I want love to be with it. Now, integration between a warehouse system and a logistics system, which is what is an Oracle product. Now, who is going to do this innovation for them? Who is going to give a creative solution for them? So we do innovative solutions like that, whether when there is a business problems like this, either enriching the product beyond Oracle, because Oracle once it does this product, it will not give you any scope to touch and feel more than that. So we will enlarge the product in the scope of the business. We will bring interfaces to them. We will give business solutions to them. That's where our innovation team continuously works to bring a lot of innovation to the products itself. That's it.
Yeah, hello, ma'am. My name is Rahul Zadho. I'm from Operations Branch. My question to you is, you talked about Internet of Things in hiring new people. So I just want to know, how are you using Internet of Things in your products, like the supply chain solutions that you offer to your customers?
Yeah, so today it's just Internet of Things is also integrating lot of mobile with solutions. So that's one more thing. With all data analytics, with all machine learning and things like that, which is all the IoT driven things, and we are putting smack IT, that's what which we call about. So we are using a lot of mobile technology into enriching those things which we are working on. So we're bringing a lot of solutions around mobile technology, around giving a lot of analytics to them to enrich for themselves to be there as an IoT driven SCM solution.
On behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I express my profound gratitude to our guest, Annapurna Madam, for sparing her valuable time to guide us for a successful career. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence and immensely benefited by your inspiring address, especially where you mention about to sustain, you have to adapt the change. About the VUCA, and the other thing, one need to keep himself up to date with the technologies. Ma'am also covered various aspects of data, statistics and analytics. I would also like to thank our beloved Bala sir for his guidance and providing us such a stimulating and learning environment. Thank you to all.